Hey guys, today I'm downtown LA. I'm going to catch the Lakers versus Charlotte Hornets regular season NBA game. Super excited. Not so much about the game itself, more like I'm able to watch one of my childhood idol, LeBron James, live on NBA court. I really splurged for this NBA ticket. You know, like for an NBA ticket, there's about maybe like 40 to 50 rows, and I will be seated in section 101, row 1. Surrounding the NBA court, there is those like courtside seats whereby you can see a bunch of celebrities like Jack Nicholson, all these watching the game. So being in row 1 is like basically the seats right behind those courtside seats. So I'll be super near LeBron. Maybe I can find a way to grab his attention or something later. So I spent almost $800 on this near courtside ticket, and the reason I do so is because growing up there was 3 NBA players that really inspired me a lot as a kid watching NBA in Singapore. So they were like Allen Iverson, Steve Nash and LeBron James. And unfortunately, being like tens and thousands of kilometers away in Singapore, I did not have the opportunity to watch AI and Nash. And right now, being in US, LeBron in year 20, I really do not want to miss the opportunity to watch LeBron before he retires. So I really splurged on this ticket. Okay, super lucky day. So you know, like buying a ticket to watch a specific NBA player these days is always very risky because players these days tend to like just sit out games randomly to rest. So you can't really anticipate that, right? And LeBron at age 20, there is always a chance that he might get injured during some games and not play. So I really don't know. But the good news is that based on LeBron's latest Instagram post, he kind of announced that he will be playing tonight, which is really good news because that is literally like the only reason that I bought the Lakers ticket today, and I'm super pumped right now. And right now it's only 4:30 p.m. The game will not start until 7:30 p.m. so I'm like super early. There's still 3 hours to go before the game starts. I guess my plan will be just sit around and visit the exterior of the arena. And until the earliest time that fans are allowed to enter the arena, I'll be one of the earliest to enter the arena and just like visit the interior of the place and maybe to see whether I can catch any player or hopefully LeBron warming up on the court. So that would be my plan.
1 hour later.
Show of hands. Okay, people already started queuing up, so I better get going.
Unfortunately, the selfie stick that I was using to hold my camera was not allowed in the arena, so I had to toss it, but it's fine. Got this free beanie though, which is really cool. I see Pat Bev and some of the young players, but I do not see LeBron, so maybe he's inside the locker room preparing for the game. I can literally see the scorer's table from here, so LeBron will probably be doing his patented powder toss later.
After a long wait, LeBron suddenly appeared out of nowhere, and seeing him face to face felt so surreal.
God, that's LeBron James.
When LeBron and the Lakers came back to the court to prepare for tip-off, I and the boy seated beside me tried to draw LeBron's attention by shouting his name whenever he walks close.
Mm.
Wait for it.
And here comes the patented puddle toss that we have all been waiting for.
High game so far, x67. So it's always good to come and see a close game because it's more fun that way. Hopefully the second half will be more exciting as well and LeBron can make a push. Yep.
LeBron continued to dominate in the second half, carrying the Lakers. And it felt ridiculous that he's still by far the best player on the court at age 37. Although this is not a good year for the Lakers, fans in the arena are still really passionate about the team. My favorite moment of the game was when Lakers finally took the lead and fans in the arena all stood up to chant. And watching LeBron carrying the team, making shot after shot, it really brought back a lot of great memories from my teenage days when I first watched him on TV. It's always the heroes you watch growing up who gave you the most inspiration, and these heroes stay with you for life.